Our next subset of compounds that we're going to look at are also of the type AXn, where X, or our ligand, is going to be either oxygen or sulfur. Remember that oxygen and sulfur both have 6 valence electrons. So to form an octet, oxygen and sulfur must share 2 electrons from the central atom. So they're going to contribute 0 electrons to the bonding around the central atom. And they can get away with this because they're both fairly electronegative. So let's look at CO2. And the first set of complexes we're going to look at will require a double bond in order to reach an octet. Our central atom is going to be carbon in this case. Carbon has 4 valence electrons. Oxygen, there's 2 of them, but they are not going to contribute any electrons as a ligand to the central atom. So that means they have to have 4 electrons around them, or 2 pairs. This means we're going to have 2 bonding pairs and 0 lone pairs. If we have 2 pairs, the hybridization is sp. The electron domain geometry is going to be linear. And the molecular geometry, since there are 0 lone pairs, is also going to be linear. So let's go about and try to draw the Lewis structure for this. In this case, we have an oxygen, where we have 2 oxygens bound to the central atom of carbon. In this case, the oxygen on the left has an octet, the oxygen on the right has an octet, but the carbon does not have an octet. And unlike complexes we looked at with boron and beryllium, carbon will not violate the octet rule. So in order to reach an octet, we have to form a double bond. And now we have 4 electrons. So we can take one of these electron pairs and form a double bond, which would give us 6 electrons around the carbon. And then we can take this second lone pair and form a double bond to get our CO2 molecule that's going to look something like this. So we have a carbon now with 2 double bonds, one on each side, giving a total of 8 valence electrons. And our oxygen have 4 lone pair electrons and 4 bonding electrons, and each oxygen has an octet as well. So we need to form a double bond in this case to form this molecule. And this molecule is going to be nonpolar because it's completely symmetric. Another example we can look at is SO2. And in SO2, we have sulfur as our central atom. It has 6 valence electrons. Oxygen, we have 2 of them. But remember, as a ligand, oxygen will not contribute any valence electrons. So this gives us a total of 6 electrons, or 3 pairs. Of these pairs, we only have 2 bonding pairs and 1 lone pair. So our hybridization is going to be sp2. Our electron domain geometry is going to be trigonal planar. If we have an electron domain geometry is trigonal planar with 1 lone pair, our molecular geometry is going to be bent. And we can draw this particular molecule with the sulfur as a central atom with a lone pair of electrons around it and with an oxygen on either side in this bent geometry. Now, when we do this, we can count up the total number of electrons on the sulfur. We have two electrons in the lone pair, two down here on the bonding pair on the left, and two down here on the bonding pair on the right. So this gives sulfur 6 electrons, which is not going to work very well because we need an octet. So what has to happen is one of these pairs of electrons is going to have to form a double bond with the sulfur. The question is, does the oxygen on the left form the double bond, or does the oxygen on the right form the double bond? And the question is, which one of these structures is going to be the preferred structure? It just so happens, and anytime you have a preferred structure, it's going to be a structure with the lowest energy. It just so happens that these two structures have the same energy, and we refer to structures with the same energy as resonance structures. And what happens is, since these structures have the exact same energy, this double bond can kind of flip back and forth between each of these two, and they're going to exist in resonance. And in addition, this molecule is also going to be polar. So when we look at SO2 and CO2, these are examples of compounds with oxygen as the ligand where you must form a double bond in order to satisfy the octet of the central atom.